Imagine getting a big break in Hollywood or the gaming industry, and the first thing you do is complain that the very person you are is the person that does not get the big breaks. What's going on, guys? Welcome to another episode of Smash JT. The star of Star Wars Outlaws, Humberly González, is claiming that the video game industry is just so full of limitations and misogyny. The person playing the role of a female lead in a big time game and a big time property is complaining that females don't get roles in big time games in big time properties. What is the deal with these people and this mentality? Can't we just be happy that you have an opportunity to showcase what your skills are and that maybe you and your skills and success can push the industry forward on its own? Nah, maybe that's asking too much. Hit that subscribe, give me a like, and check out smashjt.com for the full article discussing how the lead in Star Wars Outlaws is really angry at especially men and gamers and blaming this on the toxic gaming culture where it doesn't allow female leads to be leading in stories. And I'm not even going to get through this list of how many games just off the top of my head. Let me go. We got Metroid, Last of Us Parts 1 and 2, Bayonetta, Kena, Bridge of Spirits, Hellblade, Senua's Sacrifice, Horizon, Zero Dawn, Tomb Raider. I mean, the list goes on and on for these mega properties. Huge, many first-party games that star female leads. And for whatever reason, apparently, that wasn't good enough, and now another one in Star Wars of all properties in a massive game has a only female lead with no male choice. We're gonna go straight to the misogyny thing? Really? A tale as old as time itself. Blaming misogyny and limitations because of the patriarchy, of course. Humberly González, the lead actress in Ubisoft's floundering new release, Star Wars Outlaws, is making headlines for some pretty controversial statements about the game industry in particular. In a recent interview with Comics Gaming Magazine, or CGM, González claimed that the industry tends to have a lot of limitations and misogyny, and kind of in and out of politics of who can be part of it and who you want to play as. Which I guess is true to an extent, but that's the same with literally every walk of life. You can say that. The only reason someone would bring this up is if they're trying to push a narrative and an agenda to get more roles in the future, to make more money themselves, and maybe, who knows, maybe she's trying to create a path for more females to have leads in games in the future. But blaming the industry is not the best way to do that. Especially when I think a lot of people would agree that over the last decade or even more, there's been a ton of progress made in this area. But yet, for whatever reason, she gets a lead role and it seems to be the first thing we hear out of her. González plays the role of Kay Vess, celebrated Ubisoft and Massive Entertainment for their choice to focus solely on a female point of view, stating, "I am incredibly proud of the team for having chosen someone like me. But also only me." She emphasized the significance of not having a male alternative in the game, where it forces the player to select her as the only choice, which is fascinating to me because I feel like for the longest time we had people arguing, oh, we need more options. We should be able to customize everything and be able to create our own character in every game because we want to live our own fantasies the way we want to. When in reality, the real gamers out there, at least the vast majority that I talk to, and myself included, just want to play a good game. I really don't give a crap about what the character is at the beginning. As long as the game's fun and it's an interesting story that really engages you and brings you into the world, it doesn't matter. Boy, girl, android, machine, robot, alien, literally anything, as long as the game is entertaining and fun, and most importantly, good. González's comments were framed around the idea that the video game industry has long been plagued by sexism and exclusionary practices. She praised Star Wars Outlaws for breaking new ground by focusing on a female character in a role traditionally occupied by male figures, especially in the Star Wars lore, where I would argue there's plenty of female representation in Star Wars. There's plenty of black representation. Hell, there's plenty of every representation in Star Wars in the Star Wars universe in a series that was created in the 70s, before any of this DEI stuff even created in the first place, Star Wars was far ahead of its time in letting inclusion, diversity, and equity just naturally be a part of the universe. But yet it blows my mind that Star Wars, of all properties, seems to be the one that all these misogynistic women that just hate men and just want more girl power always go to Star Wars and say, yeah, it's misogynistic and there's not enough representation in this universe that is literally created on the basis foundation of representation. So the representation is incredible for me as an immigrant Latina in Canada to bring what it means to me as an artist. So it's somebody that focuses on their race, their gender, where they're from, who they are, as to why they got the job, basically stating that their political ideologies and who they are is what's most important. Not the game itself, not what they're doing around it, not why she is the one in charge, but everything about where she was born and what she looks like, which to me completely blows my mind when she's put in the position of being the main star and main character of a huge property. Especially when you consider that early sales data indicates that Star Wars Outlaws is performing about 55% lower than the predecessor of Star Wars Jedi Survivor. And I have to pair all this with the obvious elephant in the room that John Trent wrote so eloquently at thatparkplace.com. I mean, this dude is legit undefeated with what he researches. Ubisoft Quebec's creative Scott Phillips revealed that when Assassin's Creed Odyssey players were given the choice to choose between Alexios or Cassandra, over two-thirds of them chose the male character Alexios. So right there, we show gamers having the choice between a male and female lead, and most gamers are saying, yeah, I'll pick the male lead in the game. Like, it has a choice, and they pick that. And now this lead character of Star Wars Outlaws is trying to say, oh no, you're the problem because you're selecting men to play as. Like, isn't that representation? If there's an overwhelming amount of men playing the game and they want to feel represented in the game, shouldn't they be picking the man? I feel like they try to fit the narrative and agenda when convenient for what their story is. And when it's not, it's always someone else's fault. And this is echoed when looking at Metacritic and the very lukewarm scores. Lukewarm, yeah, I know what I just did there. The very lukewarm scores of Star Wars Outlaws, with the Metacritic score currently at 76. And I mean, I guess 76 is technically above average, but in the modern era of AAA games, where every game needs to be perfect because there are so many other choices out there, that if you get a 76, I'm sorry, I just don't have time to play it. Not to mention massive outlets like Eurogamer giving it a 40, saying Massive bravely peels away the many layers of Ubisoft open worldisms in Star Wars Outlaws. It's a fatal error. González's remarks on the gaming industry are riddled with misogyny and in-and-out politics, and it sparked quite the conversation around the gaming water cooler these days. This interview took place a couple of weeks ago, and now it's just coming to light, and everyone's like, holy crap. People were like mad that Ubisoft like uglified her in the game and people were trying to defend her. And now they see these comments from her and were like, eesh, this is who she was? To be a leading woman, not just in Star Wars story, but in the video game industry, that has a lot of limitations and misogyny. Does it? Because there are plenty of females out there in leads in many huge properties right now that would argue the complete opposite. This just feels like a political agenda that she's trying to push forward to give a narrative that women and girls just don't get the attention and leads in games that they deserve and that they should. And it's unfair, and we need more girls in gaming, which honestly, I wouldn't argue with. I feel like that's a good thing if it makes sense in the context for the game that you're playing. But forced DEI injections of female leads and female injection just to make more girls in games is not the answer. And right there is the problem. Someone saying stuff like this is not a gamer. They are a political activist trying to push propaganda and an agenda down your throat. And gamers vehemently have denied this time and time again. And it feels like one of those, how many times do we need to teach this lesson, old man? Can you please just make a good game and we will buy it? I promise you, stop injecting it with stuff that doesn't need to be there to fit your own agenda. Maybe that's just me. Anyways, I'm going to leave it there. If you guys want more information, check out smashjt.com for the full exhaustive article. It goes into a lot more depth than I do in this video. Also, huge shout out to thatparkplace.com and John Trent, who always do such amazing, incredible legwork. So check out them as well. If you appreciate what I'm doing, hit that join button. Thank you so much for watching. And as always, you stay smashing.
Villains get judged a lot. And I think there's always layered reasons in there. Smash.